Study today the noun. Okay? In English. The English noun. The noun in Arabic means the ism. Okay? And we are going to see types of noun in English grammar. First of all, we start with the definition. What is a noun? If you go to your dictionary and you write the noun, it gives you a definition. Okay? What does the word mean? Okay? So a noun is a part of speech, it's a definition, which is used to identify a thing, a person, idea, or a place. So it's a part of speech. In English grammar, it's called a part, a noun is a part of speech. Why we use a noun? It's necessary, it's very important, because we need it to identify. You remember identify before? Identify. What do we identify? We can identify a person, okay? Like Karima, Fatima, man, woman, etc. We can identify a thing, a desk, a cupboard, a table, etc. And we can identify an idea, happiness, sadness, etc. Or we can identify a place. We live in Morocco. Morocco is a noun, okay? So a noun is used to identify a person, a thing, an idea, or place. So this is just the definition before we go into detail. Everything people talk about needs a name. We need to have names. We need to have a name for things, for places, for people. We need to have that. Like in the last week, we need to have a verb. Now we need to have names for things, for person, for an idea, for people, etc. So we need, when we want to talk about people, like, for example, a man, a woman, a professor, a teacher, an artist, a pianist, a king, a minister, etc. Places, we can ask, say, street, town, Morocco, Paris, etc. Objects, things, mobile, cupboard, a chair, a desk, etc. These are names. Qualities means ideas, okay? You cannot put the idea in your hand, okay? Like, for example, happiness, sorrow, and sadness, etc. Okay? And substances is like a glass, copper, material like copper, etc. Measures. You measure things with meter, with kilometer. In British English, you don't use the meter. You use feet. You use some, but it's the same. You say ounce instead of kilos. You say inch, etc. This is British English. Actions, dances, women, and this naming word is called a noun. So the naming is called a noun. So this is simply the definition of the noun. Okay, so you have the noun, which are used to name person, a thing, an idea, substance, etc. And now when we go to something else, we are going to see the pronoun. You have pronoun. And you have the noun. Pronoun is like the noun. Okay? For example, Karima is doing her homework. She. I don't want to repeat Karima again. And I replace it with a pronoun. A pronoun. So it's a noun, but different. So you have the pronouns, which are going also to be studied in this lesson. And they are called a subclass of nouns. subclass. The big class is noun. Sub means small. Small class, the small class is called pronouns. Pronouns, I, he, she, it, her, all these are pronouns. We are going to see all the types of pronouns. John got a new job. John is my noun. Ism, John. Okay, you can replace it with Fatima, Muhammad, etc. So it's a name of a person. And we call it in English grammar, it's a noun. Instead of John got a new job, I can replace John by a pronoun. And the pronoun is he, not she. Okay, he or I, etc. He, you use it for the third singular. He got a new job. Children should watch less television. Children here is a noun, okay? It's a noun. It names people, okay? People who are small, we call them children. Okay, this is a noun. I can replace children by a subclass. Noun, by a subclass noun. This subclass noun is a pronoun. Children, I can replace it by they, because it's plural, okay? They should watch less television. So we call this pronoun I, he, she, it, you, we, they. We call them personal pronouns. Personal pronouns. All right? And you have the first, second, third in front of you. These pronouns also have another set of forms which we show here. For example, in the first and second and third, we have the following. When I say it's me, it's you, it's them. Okay, these are also called pronouns. They are subclass of nouns. The big class is nouns, the subclass is pronouns. And we have the personal pronouns that you know, I, he, she, it. And we have another set of pronouns like me, you, him, her, it. Okay, when I say I eat, I is a personal pronoun, okay? It's a personal pronoun. What is its job here in English? It is the subject, الفعل, I eat, أنا أكل, okay? But when I say it's me, is it the subject? No, it is not the subject. Okay, it is something else. So when you have the personal pronoun, you, he, she, it, we, you, and they all the time, they function, they door, l'i'rab in Arabic, l'i'rab. So the personal pronoun's function is always subject. He eats, he goes, we go, etc. Who goes? It's we. Okay? And the second class, me, you, him, etc., it's not in the subject. It's not the subject, but it's in the object. So, for example, it's him, or it's them, or it's her. It's her, it means she did the work. She did the work. She is the subject. But when it is not the subject, it is the object. The distinction between the two cases relates to how they can be used in sentence. For instance, in our first example above, we say that he can replace John. John got a new job. I can replace John by a personal pronoun. He, not she, or it, because it is third. But he cannot replace he cannot replace John in I gave John a new job. I gave John a new job. Can I say I gave he a job? But I say I gave him. Okay? So two types of personal pronouns. Two types of personal pronouns. The first, I, you, she, it, he, we, you, they, always replace a subject. Subject. But me, her, them, him, it, etc., they replace not the subject, but the object, direct object, like here. I gave John a new job. I gave John a new job. So I gave him. I don't say I gave he. Why? Why he is wrong? Because here it is an object. John here is an object. When it is an object, I cannot change it with the personal pronoun first category. I, she, he, it. No. But the second category. The second category is me, you, him, her, it, them, etc. Us, you. Okay? So the first is me, the second you, him, her, it, and the plural is us and you. So this is very important. You have to know the difference between the subject and the object. Subject الفاعل and the object الفاعل. And in English, we have two types of objects we will study that. For the time being, what is important for you to know is that the first category of personal pronoun, they replace subject. The second class of pronoun, they replace object. Now, just remember this. Later, we will go to more details. Okay, now we are going to see other type of pronouns in English. Alright, other types of pronouns. So we don't have only personal pronouns, but there are other types of pronouns in English. We start with the possessive pronouns. Possessive, what does it mean? Possessive, to possess. Milky. So there are some pronouns that are used to express what? To express possession. Possession. Limitia. Okay? Like? Mine. This is mine. Okay? This is yours. This is his. This is hers. This is theirs. Okay? This amphitheater is ours. It is ours. Okay? It is ours at the time being. Alright? So these are pronouns in English, and we call them possessive because they express possession. Milkia. Okay? My Lord, his, hers, ours. The white car is mine. The white car is mine. Okay. Another type of pronouns in English. So we have personal pronouns, and we have possessive pronouns, and we have reflexive pronoun. Reflexive means it reflects to the person. You know, like the mirror, when you see yourself in the mirror, you see yourself. So this is a reflection. So this is the meaning of reflexive. Reflexive means here, the pronouns like myself, yourself, himself, herself, itself, oneself, ourselves, yourselves, themselves. These are called reflexive pronouns. And the example here, in German, himself, playing football, he injured himself. Why himself and not herself? Because it's his. Okay, it's masculine. It's a masculine. So this is reflexive. Myself, yourself, etc. Reciprocal. Reciprocal pronouns are like each other, one another, each other, one another. So when you say, when you see each other and one another, you call these each other, you call it reciprocal pronoun. The example is they really hate each other. They really hate each other. Reciprocal mutabadil. Okay, this is in Arabic if you want. I shouldn't use Arabic, but sometimes I feel that sometimes maybe it helps you, so I sometimes use some words in Arabic. So to help you. But sometimes I don't have the Arabic word, so I leave it. Relative pronoun, because the grammar is not the same. Yeah. Relative pronoun. So relative pronouns are like that. This is the man that I know. That I know. Which, this is the cat which I saw. Which, whose, this is the girl whose father is dead. Whose is a relative pronoun. Whom, where, and when. The book that you gave me was really boring. That, in English grammar, we call it relative pronoun. Another type of pronouns is called demonstrative. Demonstrative, when you show. When you show. Demonstrate. You show something. So you say this mobile, that girl. You use this for close. You use this to show that the person or the thing is near. You show that when it is far. Okay? That man. That man. That woman. Okay? You say this, that, these, those. Okay? You say these for near, and you use those for far. Okay? So demonstrative. Interrogative. Interrogative pronoun, you use it when you want to make a question in English. And you have who, you have what, you have why, you have where, and you have when, and you have whatever. What did he say to you? What is called interrogative pronoun. And the last one is indefinite pronoun. Indefinite pronoun. Indefinite pronoun, we use it for to speak about something or somebody you don't know. Unknown. You cannot identify someone, for example, someone, anyone, anything, something. Okay, anything, anybody, anyone, something, somebody, someone, nothing, nobody, none, and no one are called indefinite pronouns in English grammar. And you have an example here. There's something in my shoe. There's something in my shoe. Something here is called indefinite pronoun. So we repeat from the beginning. The lesson. The lesson is called the English noun. Alright? Noun. The first one, I gave you the definition, the dictionary. The dictionary definition of the noun, what a noun is. Then after that, I gave you an example of a noun. Then after that, we said that a noun is the big class. Under this big class, there is a small class, which is called subclass. Sub means small, subclass. Okay? And this subclass is called pronouns. And in pronouns, in English grammar, you have personal pronouns that you know very well. Okay? And in the personal pronouns, you have two types. You have the personal pronouns which replace subject. I, you, they, them, we, it, he, she. And the personal pronoun which do not replace subject, but replace object. And it's, again, it's like me, it's him, it's her, etc. So these are the personal pronouns that replace the subject. The object. All right, I gave John a book. I gave Mohammed a book. Okay, I gave him. So him here is a personal pronoun that replaces the object, okay? And then we move to the other types of pronouns in English grammar. So either we can follow the order or we can mix them up, it's no problem. We have possessive pronouns, okay? We have reflexive pronouns. We have reciprocal pronouns. We have indefinite pronouns. We have demonstrative pronouns. All these are called subclass of the noun. Yes.
How?
Yeah, how? It is, yes, it is. Well, sometimes you don't have everything. Sometimes the list is long and it's mentioned just a few things, but it is an interrogative, yeah. It is an interrogative pronoun, yeah. Okay, so here that's about it. And we move to the types of noun, the types of noun. Like we have seen in the first lesson, types of verbs, now we are going to see the types of noun, the big class. There are many types. We start with the proper noun. Proper noun. Proper noun is like Mohammed, Fatiha, Khadija, etc., Fatima, etc. Okay, Hayat. My proper noun is Hayat, okay? So a proper noun is a specific name of a person, not just a person, but a place. Like when I say Morocco, Morocco is a proper name of the country, okay? Place or thing, and is always capitalized. What does it mean capitalized? It means it's written with a capital letter. You cannot write your name without a capital letter. It's wrong in English. You cannot write Morocco with a small m. It's wrong. Paris. with big P. Agadir, wisdom, Casablanca, all the time, all these words must be written with a capital letter. So the, a proper noun, the first definition of proper noun is a noun that is always written with a capital letter. And what is a proper noun? It identifies a person, or a place, or a thing. For example, we have Mr. Mohammed Karimi. Okay, Mohammed is a proper noun.